guys, thank you so much for joining us today on this episode. I understand that you both ended up creating blogs with your experiences on Datto networking. Just to start with you, Scott, I understand that you were in a hotel setting it up just from scratch. What were your first impressions like?
So my first impression was that, well, how am I going to do this? Because all of the boxes arrived. I had all new equipment that hadn't been configured. I was expecting it to be very difficult. And it turns out the hardest thing for me was getting the boxes open, because the knife that I had couldn't carry a regular knife on a plane. I had one of those little plastic knives, and trying to open up the tape to get into the boxes was the hardest part. Everything else was easy. It was a matter of unboxing it, plugging it all in. It just went really, really smoothly. And it was something that I was expecting the worst and got the best.
Now, Henry had almost like an opposite experience in the sense that you were setting it up in a restaurant in this case.
Yes, that's correct.
How was that in comparison to, so Scott's by himself in a hotel room. You, on the other hand, are in this like restaurant setting. What would you say the differences for you were like?
Well, I was setting it up actually in my mother-in-law's restaurant, which she had experiences of losing internet. So I was like, wow, DNA can come out and jump right in and take, 4G LTE failover. That's like a huge thing, because, you know, you need to be able to submit tickets and that sort of thing through, you have to have internet to do it properly. So like, I wanted to get my hands on it as soon as possible. So I did. And basically all I had to do was plug it in and take out the old router and switch and just plug everything in as needed.
Now guys, in comparison to each of your experiences, what were some of the complications that you each went through when setting it up for the first time?
Yeah, it was, setting everything up was really easy. I mentioned earlier that getting into the boxes was a little hard. The boxes were also pretty heavy, so that was another challenge. I had to get them from the hotel lobby back up to my room.
Like carrying stuff.
And the reality is that I understand what switches are, I understand what the router is, I understand what the Wi-Fi access points are. So it was a matter of just simply plugging things into the right place, which was not hard to do. It was very, very clearly defined. Even when I even opened up the DNA box, it had little diagrams on each of the compartments where the antennas were and the power supply. So it told me, this is what you need for here. You open it up and it's right there. It was really, really nicely packaged. Very, very simple. I didn't really find any complications as I was going to set it up.
Well, I actually don't think, I mean, I didn't really experience a complication in setting it up, but I needed to take, a little bit of time to see what my mother-in-law for her restaurant needed. And in reality, what she needed was to make sure that she could send her orders to the back of the house, and also process credit cards, but also have that guest Wi-Fi.
How would you feel a partner who is like a veteran partner, for example, someone who's been with us for years? How do you think they would set up Datto networking in comparison to maybe a partner who is like a one-stop shop, who's maybe an MSP for the first time? Like how would they compare?
I think the simplicity, I think, comes into play for both of them. So somebody who has years of experience, has a lot of employees, has large customers, they're going to love the way that everything gets configured in the cloud. And they're going to love the fact that you simply plug it in and it's working. And you have the opportunity to go in and change some of the settings, but it's really, really simple to do. Setting up an SSID for a guest network, for example, was a breeze. We did that for the show where we were. Set up a guest network with a password. You can set up a login page and things like that. And I didn't have to know anything to do that. I just simply indicated that I wanted to do it, and it was, I entered a couple of things and a couple of clicks, and it was that simple.
So guys, for partners who would like to get more involved with our networking developments, where can they reach out, or how can they get a hold of us?
Well, it's actually really easy. We try to make it as easy as possible. If they're already a partner, an IT service provider can go to community.datto.com and start posting in there. They can even, from the partner portal, get a product and start trying it, obviously, and then give us the feedback that they've used, what they've seen. Our product team, including ourselves, as well as the actual developers, are on that all the time to make sure that they're hitting what they need to be doing.
And if they want to learn, if it's somebody who's not a current partner, they want to learn a little bit more. Henry and I did a webinar a few weeks back that is available. It's on our website, datto.com. So in that webinar, we talk about at a high level some of the capabilities, and we go into some a little bit more detail. It's not a really, really deep technical dive presentation, but that is available as well through our systems engineers and our sales team. So if that is something of interest, we have those resources available as well.
Great. Well, gentlemen, thank you both for joining us today. We really appreciate your insight in Datto networking.
Glad to be here.
If you'd like to learn more about Datto networking, watch Henry and Scott's webinar on our website.